Hello, I'm back. I am Jack Remington, your host. The 3M Mask Malfeasance. Hospitals and medical facilities across America are struggling to get the appropriate PPE, or personal protection equipment, needed for the frontline workers in the war against the Wuhan coronavirus, or also called COVID-19. On March 24th, President Trump signed an executive order to prevent the hoarding of PPE and essential medical supplies needed in the fight against COVID-19. Yesterday, the home of a 43-year-old man, Brooklyn man, who lives in the state of hit hardest by the coronavirus pandemic, was raided by the FBI and was caught hoarding an incredible amount of invaluable PPE. According to ABC News, the despicable Brooklyn citizen was selling the PPE for profit to doctors and nurses for as much as 700% above fair market value. Hundreds of thousands of masks and other pieces of medical equipment seized from the Brooklyn man will be distributed to medical workers on the front lines treating the coronavirus patients. According to the Department of Justice, the equipment includes roughly 192,000 N95 respirator masks, 600,000 medical gloves, 130,000 surgical masks, procedure masks, N100 masks, surgical gowns, disinfectant towels, bottles of hand sanitizer, and disinfectant spray.
We have exclusive video tonight of the FBI raiding the home of a man in Borough Park, Brooklyn, a man who allegedly coughed on FBI agents and told them he had coronavirus. The agents were investigating 43-year-old Baruch Feldman for allegedly hoarding medical supplies, including masks and gowns, and selling them to doctors and nurses at a markup, in some cases up to 700%. Investigators charged him with assaulting a federal officer and lying to law enforcement.
As this turns out, the 43-year-old Brooklyn man isn't the only one who's putting his fellow citizens behind making a profit. Last night, we reported about Jared Moskowitz, director of Florida Emergency Management for his state.
That person is Jared Moskowitz. He's the director of the Florida Division of Emergency Management, and we're happy to have him on tonight. Jared, thanks so much for coming on. So, simple question. Repeat for our audience, if you would, what you told me about your efforts to get masks for your state, which, by the way, is your job.
Yeah, no, thanks, Tucker. I appreciate you having me on. I appreciate you featuring this story. It's important. For the last several weeks, we've had like a boiler room in our EOC chasing down 3M authorized distributors, brokers, supposedly representing that they sell N95 masks, only to get to warehouses that are completely empty, being told that our shipments are on cargo planes and the flights don't even appear on FlightAware. We're chasing ghosts, Tucker. You know, I just decided to turn up the heat and tell people what is actually happening in the N95 mask space. And so, you know, 3M reached out to us today. Their government relations folks wanted to have a conversation. And I thought perhaps maybe what 3M would finally say to me is that they have masks to sell me. But what I actually found out is even more frightening. It's what we suspected, which is that the system is completely broken. The authorized distributors who right now can't tell me a timeline when I'm going to receive my masks orders that I put in a month ago. And by the way, the terms and conditions are, you know, I got to pay for the masks and can't cancel my order, is that 3M has lost total control. And so what I asked 3M is that, are they aware that their authorized distributors, U.S. companies, are telling me that the reason why our orders are being pushed down is because foreign countries are showing up with cash to purchase the orders. And so when I asked 3M, you know, what is your production? They said they're making 10 million masks a week. And when I said, great, I have money, I'd like to purchase some of those, they said I couldn't, that they have no mask to sell me. And this is, it's criminal what's happening, Tucker. And I want to say something very clear. This is not about the workers in the factories at 3M who are working 24 hours a day to try to create this life-saving PPE. This is about the executives who decided not to put America first. And it's going to have devastating consequences.
So just, I just want to encapsulate what you said, because I just want this to sink in for the audience. You try to get an answer. You're in charge of procuring these for the first responders in Florida. You're not some guy off the street. You're a government official trying to help a state that is becoming one of the centers of the outbreak, Florida. And you basically got the runaround. So you went after 3M on Twitter, and they responded. And people noticed it, and they responded. And you said, why can't I get it? And they basically said, we have no control. Our dealers are selling some of these masks to foreign countries because they got there first or they're paying cash. And you said, well, shouldn't you tell your distributors to make a priority for America, for the states, for the local governments, or first responders, physicians, nurses, EMTs? And they said, no, we haven't done that. Is that a fair summary?
Yeah, not only is that a fair summary, it's exactly what's happening. It's why Governor DeSantis said the other day it's shady as hell. 3M is an ice cream store that doesn't sell ice cream, apparently. I mean, since when do we have a U.S. company who sells masks and I try to offer them money and they won't sell them to me? That, you know, I have to go through their authorized distributors, and their only excuse is that they don't have a perfect system. I'm relegated to making deals with brokers at costs that are 10 and sometimes 20 times the actual cost of these masks, which, you know what, at the end of the day, Tucker, regardless of the cost at this point, getting the mask is the most important thing at the moment. We can't even get them. Because like I said,
well,
I guess for me, the rub is,
you represent Florida. And if they had said to you, look, I'm sorry, Michigan got there first, or California is on the list, or New York has a massive outbreak right now, and they need these masks. I think everyone would understand that. These masks are literally being sold to foreign countries in the middle of a pandemic from which we are suffering profoundly. Michael Roman, who's the CEO of this company, who's doing a star turn on TV, I notice, never told the distributors that this country comes first. That's just bizarre to me. It's shocking to me.
Yeah, that is not a rumor. That's not something that was suggested. The 3M authorized distributors, which there are only about 20 of those companies, 3M lists them on their website, though the 3M authorized distributors are telling me this. They're specifically saying, listen, we're sorry that your order got pushed down, but there are folks showing up to the factories. There are folks showing up to us, calling us, paying cash. And when I said, what do you mean there are folks? They said, well, listen, you know, there are foreign countries that do business differently. They're showing up with cash. The idea that an American company is selling masks away from our hospitals, away from our doctors, away from the real heroes on the front lines, is something that, you know, will long be investigated after this, but it's really criminal what is happening, that I can't, and other emergency management directors, other CEOs of hospitals can't get what this is, life-saving PPE, because a company decided to make a globalist decision and not put America first.
You know, you'd think that the government affairs guy who called you today would have thought, you know, this is pretty disgusting what I'm defending. You know, maybe I'll just send a memo to Michael Roman and say, hey, you know, Mr. CEO, you should tell our distributors to put the state of Florida above, say, China. But they didn't. Jared Moskowitz, I really am thankful that you came on tonight. That's the most vivid description I've heard. I appreciate it.
No, Tucker, thank you. I appreciate the opportunity.
This is reported from Vice. Baruch Feldheim, 43, was interviewed by FBI agents on Sunday, during the course of which he allegedly coughed on them and claimed he had the COVID-19 virus. He was arrested Monday and is now facing charges of lying to a federal agent and assault of a federal agent. The federal charging documents describe how Individual A, a traveling nurse working in nursing homes, reached out to the Virus 2020 WhatsApp group on behalf of their boss, Dr. A, in early March looking for medical supplies. Feldheim, who was in the group, responded. After negotiating through text messages and phone, he agreed to sell the nurse and doctor 3,000 surgical masks, 1,000 N95 masks, 2,000 sterile gowns, and another 800 gowns made of hazmat material for a total of $12,000. That was up over 700% markup from the normal fair market value price. The doctors and nurses wired Feldheim money into a corporation listed under his wife's name called Solo Supplies. The doctor and nurse made multiple trips to the auto repair shop in New Jersey to pick up those medical supplies. Inside the warehouse, they observed pallets full of medical supplies, boxes of N95 masks, and hand sanitizers of different brands, and many other medical supplies. On March the 20th, Feldheim told the nurse that he had to move his supplies out of the warehouse after getting complaints from the neighbors about the heavy traffic outside the auto repair shop. The FBI said they reviewed surveillance footage from a restaurant across the street and observed individuals moving large quantities of materials into a moving truck. Some of those supplies, including face masks, have been shipped from Canada. Feldheim eventually moved his operation to his home in Brooklyn, New York, where he continued to peddle medical supplies to desperate doctors and nurses. Last week, this past Sunday, two FBI agents went to interview Feldheim. After flashing their badges, they told Feldheim that they were going to stay at least 6 feet away from him, a distance from him, due to the concerns of the coronavirus. According to the documents, Feldheim got about 4 feet away from the agents and intentionally coughed in their direction without covering his mouth. When the agents said they were Investigating reports that he was hoarding much-needed medical supplies, Feldheim told him that he had the COVID-19 coronavirus himself. Feldheim isn't the first to be accused of stockpiling needed medical supplies as a part of a price-gouging scheme. Prosecutors across the country have probed similar complaints, including a Florida man who was trying to sell 15 N95 masks on Amazon for a total of $3,799, and a man in Tennessee who donated his stockpile of 17,700 bottles of hand sanitizer after the state's attorney launched an investigation. In times of crisis, we would all hope that people could pull together and work well with each other and have some empathy for the victims and have some empathy for the heroes on the line. Unfortunately, that is not the case here. And considering human nature, it will never be the case. The collective, e pluribus unum, out of many, one. We must always place systems in place and keep them there for checks and balances. We must always stay vigilant. Stay safe. Always a great day to be an American. Thanks for watching, and please share these videos and subscribe. The more people that can see this information and these videos, we can get better informed and the public can be more aware. Thank you.